I love printing.
I love it.
I f***ing love printing.
Today we are fortunate. We are beyond fortunate today to have one of my many good print friends. As I've said before, they're all my print friends. We have Christine Yardley from Print Panthers. Almost said Pink Panthers, but it's Print Panthers in Toronto, Ontario. Welcome, Christine.
Well, I'm happy to be here.
We're happy to have you here. So before I go on with all my questions, I thought I'd give you a minute or two or three. It's your time. Tell us a little bit about Print Panther and what it is that you do and like to do and makes you great.
Sure. Well, we're a boutique printer. That's what we like to call ourselves, even though we are a commercial print shop. But we do a little bit of everything. But I think our claim to fame is probably being the first, I think actually the first in Canada to have the MGI foam varnish machine, which got us into the embellishment market pretty early on, pioneered it, I think. So we're 4 years in on that, and we wanted to kind of broaden that reach a little with packaging, so we've just got a new Duplo die cutter, and we also do a Curio wide work, some wide format, large format, but really not how traditional printers would use large format. We do it mostly for specialty packaging and binders, and where I want to get a really good inkjet print off maybe larger size than I can get off my traditional machines. Also, we were, I think, one of the first in Southern Ontario to get the Xerox Iridesse. So we also do the metallic inks, the whites, that kind of thing. So we're a kind of a unique shop in that we can do a lot of specialty work that, is kind of makes us stand out from the crowd, I guess.
Well, I got to tell you, what I like right off the bat is I like that you use the word boutique to describe your company. And I think you got a bit of an advantage when you mentioned one of the first with the print embellishments and then with the Iridesse. I think it's great being a smaller size shop. I didn't tell anybody how big you are, how many people you have. You could tell us. I happen to know. But I think it's an amazing way to run your business and generate revenue. And I'm sure you don't have to answer me, but I'm going to make the assumption that your margins are probably pretty decent because you are doing stuff differently.
Absolutely. I mean, our profit margins tend to be anywhere between 25 and 40%, depending on what it is. And a couple of things that allow us to do that. One is obviously the quality of work we do. Everything's kind of bespoke, but also we do a lot of the creative input too. And we'll often do the creative part of it as an added value so that we can get the print job by doing the creative. So if our profit margin sits around the 40%, it kind of covers off that a little.
How's COVID been for you?
Well, you know, it's been interesting. I mean, I can't believe that, you know, March 13th was kind of the day that it kind of began here where we are located. And it just seemed like it was going to be a short-term thing. And suddenly we've, you know, almost got 8 months or 9 months. And we have been lucky because we were able to stay open the entire time. One of our clients is a healthcare account, which actually has been busier during COVID, which is a little bit of a bonus. But, you know, it's also given us time to drill down on what we need in the shop, what we don't need in the shop. And that goes for machinery and people and you know, what we want to do moving forward and how we want to differentiate moving forward, because we've always tried to be different, right? So it's been an odd time, but it's actually been an interesting time. I've done lots of conferences. I did one a month or so ago with a company in the UK, Future Print, and, you know, met people.
Saw that. That was great.
Yeah, never met those people before. I'm doing one on Wednesday with Konica US for embellishment. So, you know, it's been interesting. Now, we just before the pandemic, like literally days before, we had done a partnership with Print 3 for their franchises to bring them into the embellishment world. And unfortunately, that kind of came to a screeching halt because I couldn't go to the different franchises and talk to them about embellishment. And so that sort of got shelved a little, but we're starting to unpackage it again and maybe do some Christmas cards for the franchises and get them into the embellishment world through that side of things. So, I mean, COVID's been interesting in that we've been steady and, you know, I think we've done some amazing work through it. We've been really blessed, actually.
Oh, by the way, just a quick idea before I forget it, because I forget things quickly. With Print 3, they've got a lot of franchises, right?
I think 50.
Okay, I would ask the management to give you the top 10 only, just a suggestion, top 10 only, and start working with them, because those are the ones that really push what they do and will grasp what you're doing better. And if you succeed with the top 10, roll it out to the rest, roll it out to all of them at once. A lot of franchises in print don't do amazing just because of ownership, leadership, whatever it might be. So just an idea of mine to pass on so that you can get maybe ramp it up, or take the top five, even his best producers, and get some traction.
Yeah. I mean, it's an interesting one. I don't know, you know, from a price point of view, how many it would actually sit with, but you're right. The top producers should be able to sell that kind of high end stuff.
So that sounds really good. So it sounds like you've been busy. I also, from what I understand, just because I read all the trade stuff, you just bought a Duplo die cutter a month ago.
Yes. We were doing a lot of specialty stuff, packaging, and even, you know, some different shaped business cards, and sending out a ton of die cutting. And this little Duplo was quite amazing. I mean, smaller sheet size, but the sheet size marries to our Iridesse and the MGI, so it works for us. And we can pretty much get anything off it we really want. And it's a great little machine. I mean, it's quick. So we can do like pocket folders now with odd shaped pockets.
What's the sheet size on it?
It's a 13 inch by whatever length, right? So,
oh, cool.
And it's a great little machine. He's, you know, a little bit of a learning curve, at the start, but we've kind of got it down now, and, always software stuff, you know, but it's, I really like it. And just to be able to do stuff, even samples, you know, in-house now, not having everything go out to the die cutter. We have our other Duplo that would do our cards and stuff, but this is a true die cutter. So.
No, listen, anything that I always remembered, anything that we could do in-house is just better because you're saving time. Forget the money, but every time you give it out, it's a day to go out, a day to do it, a day to get it back. It's a 3-day process versus asking someone to stay in the afternoon or at night or come in early, do it and get it out of the way. It's also one less thing to worry about when it's not going out because there's enough on the list.
You know, if you have a lot of embellishment on the sheet, you wanted it to treat it gently, you know, until it really cures. So we have the added benefit of being able to, you know, take care with pieces.
You don't have to send a skid of sheets out that have been embossed that get flat by the time they get there.
Exactly.
Hey, when that happens.
Yeah, if you've worked your butt off trying to get it done.
Yeah. So I see behind you, you have a sign for Eat, Print, Love. You have a sign and I have a business card, funny enough.
That's a damn good business card.
Well, the reason I have it, and I don't really keep a lot of my business cards, is aside that I like you, I came to do the video with you when you launched Eat, Print, Love at the Dankoff Gallery at the X Hotel in Toronto. But I just thought, and I thought maybe you want to tell my big viewership of 11 what the Eat, Print, Love theme is and what it stands for, because I think it's awesome. And then from what I understand, we're just starting to roll it up again, correct?
Yeah, it seems like a million years ago that we were at the Hotel X. That was so much fun, and that was back in the days when we could actually, you know, hug and things. But now,
yeah, by the way, I just want a little promo for Hotel X. If you're in Toronto, Hotel X is an awesome hotel. For one, Neil Dankoff's prints are throughout the hotel. I produced them for him, but they have an amazing bar on the rooftop if you like to drink. And if you don't like to drink, they have tennis on the fourth floor. That's my plug for Hotel X. Great place.
Very good. It is a great place. It is in a great location. I really loved it. But that gallery was stunning, and it was a wonderful place to launch Eat, Print, Love, because, I mean, it was just all about color and print and creativity and all that stuff. And so Eat, Print, Love was just sort of something I think I dreamt it. I'm not sure. But it's sort of like, you know, everything that I see during my day, or if I'm traveling or whatever, that makes me, inspires me, right? It's all about inspiration. So I wanted Eat, Print, Love to be more engaging for designers and printers, where they could go on the site, they could get, Trish, you know, at the Fold Factory, I put all her folds up for the week. So I've archived all her folds on the site, and, you know, go there, get a template, get inspired, post a video. But I sort of lost track of it a little bit, you know, and I think all of us were sort of sidetracked with the pandemic when it started. But
what pandemic? There's no pandemic. What are you talking about?
But I also felt that I was losing track, or losing sight, maybe is a better way of saying, what I truly wanted the essence of it to be, because it's not a site to make money. It's not a site to, it's just a inspirational site. And I worried that it was losing my voice because of the social media aspect of it. So I've stepped back that, but I'm contemplating stepping back into it. I just want it to be with the right voice and the right projection. And I think
you could use my voice and projection. It's all good.
Yeah, exactly. So, but it's really just about creativity and inspiration and, what gets you inspired. And I mean, you have to inspire your clients, or, why would they use you?
I think everybody, doesn't matter what you do, I think everybody needs a little inspiration as they go along. And I really like the idea that it's not a site for selling anything. It's just more for the love of print, no pun intended.
Yeah,
right.
That's exactly what it is.
If we could eat it, we would eat it. But the truth is, I don't even think everyone realizes how impacted they are by what they see in print, color, embellishments. They probably didn't even know that it affects the way they think when they're in the store buying something. But it's all good. So, any plans coming up for you in the near future?
I was doing the embellishment conference on Wednesday, which I'm looking forward to. We've actually done I don't know if anybody ever saw the designer's guide. We actually won the Canadian Print Awards with it last year. We've just completed the designer's guide 2. And so the first 100 will be rolling off the line. So I'm hoping that does just as well at the award shows, because it was definitely a labor of love. But it's really showing off some cool ideas with embellishment and design. And it kind of kept our sanity during this time, because it's a very creative piece. So that was a lot of fun. That's kept me out of trouble. And moving forward, I mean, it's just Christmas cards from now till Christmas. Cause when you have a foil and varnish machine, you do Christmas cards.
That's what that do. Lots of Christmas cards.
Yes.
Millions of Christmas cards.
Well, I don't know about millions. If I did millions, I'd be retired.
You do deal with a lot of people on the print manufacturing side, correct? Other printers?
Yes, we do. We do trade. We do what I call preferred trade. So we're not what you'd call a commodity trade shop, but we do trade.
Well, you can't, sorry to interrupt you again. You can't be a commodity because you're doing embellishments.
That's right. So we are a trade printer. We are not a trade printer, but we will do trade. A select group that we work with. It's not the core of our business by any stretch. But I think when other printers have mostly complicated projects come our way, believe it or not, because we, a lot of handwork, fussy stuff, and we excel at that. So we tend to get it. And that includes the binders or presentation materials, that kind of thing. Because that's where we started. So in presentations. So a lot of high-end presentations, that's our core business.
Yeah, so I brought it up because one of the things that I've been hearing, where people have been talking about since the COVID started, I don't even know what to call it anymore, the COVID, the pandemic, pain in the ass, whatever. There's been a lot of talk amongst printers because a lot of printers have been having some troubles for different reasons, lack of staff, lack of money, sales, whatever, and a lot of more talk about people coming together. But one of the bigger things I've been hearing people talk about is printers helping or working with other printers. As I said before, our industry is so capital intensive that not everybody can afford to buy every single piece of equipment. But rather than go buy equipment and potentially put your business in trouble, find someone who does it and help them. And if you want to do embellishments or binders, then you want to call Christine. Yeah, but no, I think you're amazing. I think the stuff you do is really cool. Print Eat Love is, I think it's just a wonderful, you should go on the road with it. We should get you a tour bus.
And when I'm allowed to go on the road again, I shall.
Okay. I'm to drive the bus, by the way.
Okay, good. Well, I mean, I miss that touch point, I really miss the one-on-one with fellow printers.
We all do.
Yeah.
I think, by the way, it's bigger than the printers. I think people are just missing other people right now.
Yeah, I think so. And hopefully when we come through this, we will be grateful that we did come through it and we won't forget the lessons learned.
Oh God. All I know is I was a big hugger before and I'm having I'm going through the blues with this no hugging. Like even my kid pops in and she's like, no, we're moving different places. I'm like, oh my God. So hopefully we all get back. Hopefully we all get back to something like the old a little bit. I don't like the new normal.
2021. Yeah.
Perfect. Anything else you'd like to add before I kindly blow you off?
Well, it's been lovely always speaking with you. And I hope somebody tunes in and a few more people than 11. But it's been fun. It's been fun. And as always, you make me smile. And
thank you.
That's about it. You know, be kind, be safe, and take care.